In this segment, we are going to talk about the secant method. We're going to derive the secant method of finding roots of nonlinear equations. So we're going to look at the derivation of how secant method is used to solve a nonlinear equation of the form f of x equal to 0. So if you have an equation where the left-hand side is f of x, so we're going to, let's suppose we plot f of x, the left-hand side of the equation, which is the function, and we plot it as a function of x, and we find out where does it become 0, that becomes the root of the equation. So that's what we want to look for. We want to see that where does f of x become 0, and that's what we're going to derive by using this numerical method called the secant method. Now, the approach which we're going to take in order to derive it is based on Newton-Raphson method. Newton-Raphson method gives you an iterative equation of finding, or an iterative formula to find out the root of the equation f of x equal to 0. And it looks like this. So this is the iterative equation which you have to write, or which you have to use to find out the root of the equation f of x equal to 0. So basically, this recursive relationship involves that you choose some initial guess of x of I, and you get x of I plus 1. Then you plug it back in here, you get x of I plus 2, and you continue this process till you find out that your roots are within a pre-specified tolerance. Now, you can very well see that in order to be able to use this recursive relationship, you got to know what the derivative of the function f is. So that is required, as you see in the denominator there, so you have to calculate that symbolically to be able to do that. So that's one of the drawbacks of the Newton-Raphson method, that you have to calculate the derivative of the function f symbolically to be able to use the Newton-Raphson method. So one of the ways to get around it is by using an approximation for the derivative of the function. And I can approximate it as the value of the function at x of I minus the value of the function at x of I minus 1 divided by x of I minus x of I minus 1, like this. Where does this come from? This is basically your Newton's divided difference polynomial approximation of the derivative of the function, and you're using backward divided difference. So this formula looks familiar. It is, because it is the backward divided difference formula to approximate the first derivative of a function. So what you're finding out is that by taking this approximation, you are saying that, hey, I don't have to find the f prime or the derivative of the function f. No longer do I have to find it exactly. I can use an approximation instead. Now, the only thing which you are introducing, which is in addition to what we have in the Newton-Raphson method, is that you're introducing another unknown here, which is x of I minus 1. So what that means is that you have to make two guesses now. Not only will you have to guess what, or make an estimate, or have an initial guess for x of I, but also an initial guess for x of I minus 1. So you will need two initial guesses to start the process and then get a new guess. So if I look at, substitute this formula back into my Newton-Raphson method formula, I'll get something like this: x of I minus f of xi divided by f of xi minus f of xi minus 1 divided by xi minus xi minus 1. So I'm going to simplify it a little bit by taking this to the numerator, and this is what I'm going to get. I'm going to get x of I plus 1 is equal to x of I minus the value of the function x of I times x of I minus 1 divided by the value of the function x of I minus the value of the function at x of I minus 1. And that's what the secant method is. So this is the secant method formula. So secant method formula for f of x equal to 0. And what you are seeing here is that now you have to have two initial guesses, because you have x of I here, x of I minus 1. So you'll have to have two initial guesses to begin with. So once you have chosen x of I minus 1 and x of I, you'll be able to calculate this right-hand side and get x of I plus 1. Then you're going to use x of I and x of I plus 1 to get x of I plus 2. So again, you'll continue this process till you find out that
that your root has been found within a pre-specified tolerance, and that's when you will start the algorithm. But again, you got to understand that you need two initial guesses. Again, although you need two initial guesses, does not mean that this is a bracketing method. This is still an open method. So secant method is still an open method because the two initial guesses which you are going to use, they don't necessarily have to bracket the root. So although you have two initial guesses, but they don't necessarily have to bracket the root, so it still falls into the category of the open method, just like the Newton-Raphson method. And that's the end of this segment.